Welcome to Monday with Michelle and Outlay for Great. Hope you all had a fantastic weekend. I am so happy that we had a full week last week. This is the first time in a long time that we've had a video on every single day. So that was really kind of nice. And everybody did an amazing job with their videos. So if you haven't had a chance to catch up and see all the videos from last week, please do. And we had a guest on Saturday, Sama. Oh, that video was fantastic. All the resources, and Sama's awesome. And Colette, it's just so nice to have you. And just I'm really pleased with all the videos that we had last week. So this week is my turn to pick a video topic. And I put out there, recently marriage equality has finally come to the state of Florida. If you are married in a state that did recognize marriage equality, would you feel it necessary to get married yet again in your home state? If so, why? Because of the principle only? Does being legally recognized really change how you move through the world on a day-to-day basis? And I thought when I put that question out there that my answer was going to be a certain way. And then I had something really bad happen to me last week, which totally changed my idea of the answer. Originally, I would have said that, you know, since I was legally married with Kirsten in New Hampshire a year and some change ago, that now that marriage equality, since it's here in Florida, you know, we were already recognized by the government, I wouldn't have seen the need to get married yet again. And now I find out that I don't think we actually can get married again because we were legally married and now Florida has just automatically recognized us, which I'm still trying to wrap my brain around. I mean, I just can't even believe it's actually happened because I really thought we'd be one of the last states to actually have this happen. Well, so my answer would have been on the last part, does being legally recognized change how you move through the world on a day-to-day basis? I thought that that answer was going to be no. Well, last week, I had a really bad incident. Some of you might have seen on my personal channel, which is Painted Raven Song, if you're at all curious. I had a really bad event with a pinched nerve in my leg. And by the middle of last week, I was almost completely unable to walk. And the part of our residence that we live in is actually we have a two-story house. The bottom of our house is my piano teaching studio. Second floor is our residence. Well, I was actually stuck on the second floor. I literally could not even go down the stairs one day last week. And then I had a bad reaction with a muscle relaxer that was given to me. And you find out really quickly how much you depend on the person that you love to help you in when you're really hurting and having to have someone call doctors for you, etc. So when Kirsten ended up taking me to the doctor last week, well, just on Friday, so a couple days ago, and I was having to fill out paperwork and stuff, it really was actually quite a different feeling knowing that I was putting married on a form and that I was legally married. This wasn't just some label that we self-imposed, you know, because we were married in another state or whatever. We were in Florida actually legally married on Friday when we were at the doctor, and it did, it actually made me feel different. And I didn't think that was going to happen. And so, long story short, my leg is definitely getting better. I finally went downstairs, which is good. And, you know, it's a pinched nerve or something, so I'm going through, like, chiropractic massage, you know, all the stuff that you have to do for a pinched nerve. And playing my double bass is definitely not helping the matter, but, you know, you got to do what you got to do. So, yes, I really, I'm even surprised at my own change of heart on this question, because I was originally thinking, okay, so yeah, so if we're legally married, how is that really going to affect us on a day-to-day basis? You know, what really happens on a day-to-day basis that really, you know, it matters? But yeah, once you end up in the doctor's office and you're filling out, you know, person who is like the contact person, relationship to patient, spouse, wow, she's really legally my spouse now, like for real. And I think maybe that's why I changed my mind about my answer, because it's the first time that we've ever encountered it actually making a difference, because she can now, you know, speak for me if something, you know, if she needed to be my voice, she could, you know, make arrangements for my medical care, all the stuff. And it just, it's really a great thing. So it's really important that even for those of you who, you don't ever care about this, you don't care if you ever get married, blah, 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 whatever, it's still an important thing for us to have happen because of what it means for all the people that just want to be treated equally when it comes down to this exact situation that happened with me last week. So I'm just really thrilled, and I'm hoping that pretty soon all the states will be on board and it'll just be a sweeping thing and the entire nation will just be like, you know, hey, we got equality and let's just move on, you know, just give us the equality we deserve. And we'll move on to other topics. You know, it's a very important thing to have happen, but, you know, I don't want my whole life to be about my sexuality. I mean, can we just, you know, be treated like humans and get on to the business of living and doing positive things with our lives? So, all right, you all, take good care, and don't hurt yourselves or pinch any nerves, and I'll see you next week.